When one thinks about fighting climate change, the first thing that comes to mind is wind turbines or solar panels or electric cars. But look around. A huge part of the solution is the building you're sitting in right now and the buildings we're going to build nationally and globally over the next decades. One reason getting buildings right is so important as a climate change solution is because they consume about 40% of all energy, including the electricity. So if they're wasting most of that, it's very difficult to build a low carbon economy. On the other hand, if they have super efficient appliances and they're very well designed and well built, then they use very little energy. First thing you got to do is insulate really well. Don't let the heat out in the winter. Don't let the heat in the summer. The second thing is use great windows. There's this amazing invention called low emissivity windows, and you can tune them for the climate. So if you're in Minnesota, you get a window that lets in the heat and doesn't let it back out. If you're in Florida, it bounces the heat back out. You get the one you need. The third ingredient is really simple, thermal mass. Have a stone floor or concrete wall. Those will absorb heat when the building's warming up and give off heat when the building's cooling down. And it smooths everything out. If you want a great illustration of this, walk into an old church in the middle of a really hot day and feel how cool it is without an air conditioner. Overhangs for windows. An overhang keeps summer sun out and lets winter sun in. So why not? So these four ideas, simple as can be, insulation, good windows, thermal mass, and overhangs, create a building that uses almost no energy. Think of an extreme example. If you had a perfectly insulated building, you could heat it up once to 72 degrees and drop it into Antarctica and it would still be that temperature 5 years later. Now, perfection's not the goal, but pretty good we should go for. When you build a building is the best time to get it right. That's when your walls are open and you can put the insulation in. That's when you wrap the ducts. That's when you make the choices about what kinds of windows. So how do we make sure that at that moment when you're designing and building the building, it comes out really well? And the answer is very simple. You need a great building code. The best building code in the world, one could argue, is California's. So it was adopted when Jerry Brown was the youngest governor in our history. And he did a few things that are pretty genius. So one of them is he divided the state into 16 different climate zones because they have different energy requirements. So you wouldn't want to build the same building in Palm Springs that you build in Tahoe, totally different climates. The second thing is he created a mechanism to make it stronger every 3 or 4 years so that it rolls in new technology all the time and uses those technologies to make your buildings better. So that created a race for better windows, better insulation, better heaters, better air conditioners, and so forth. By making it tighten every 3 years, it means he didn't have to go back to the legislature, and neither did any of the subsequent governors. The building code just got better and better. And the consequence of that is new buildings in California use about 80% less energy compared to pre-code buildings. That's an amazing gift to California's families. Most states either have no energy building code or have an old one. They're backwards looking, they use decade-old technology. There's no reason you can't call up your building department and say, why doesn't my state have the most advanced building code in the country? So one of the big challenges is how do you fix up old buildings? What do we do with all the existing houses, shops, and offices out there? A great iconic building in America is the Empire State Building in New York City. For many years, it's the tallest building in America. In 2009, that building went through a massive retrofit. They replaced 6,500 windows in that retrofit. It was a big job, but they cut energy use by nearly 40% when they did that. That's a great asset now for the owners, for the tenants, and for the climate. A well-engineered, well-designed energy retrofit saves so much energy that it pays for itself in just a few years. And from then on, it saved money. There's an explosion of new buildings in China, in Southeast Asia, across many cities in Africa, and in India. In those countries, more than half the buildings that will exist in 2050 have not yet been built. It's absolutely crucial if we're going to save our climate that they be built as very efficient buildings with very low energy demands. So those countries need a great building code. New technology is always coming along. So if you have a building code that's 10 years old, chances are good it's not the best anymore. If you have a building code that gets tighter every few years, That kind of continuous improvement unleashes market forces to make this better and better and better. It's a great policy design trick.